Hey, brothers and sisters, I am determined by the grace of God, brothers and sisters, to keep my videos separate. And I've already got on a tangent of 10 different topics in the last video, like I always do, and I've decided to follow a single train of thought. I have decided to follow one topic. I have decided to stick with one topic. We'll see if it can happen. We'll see if it can happen. Praise God, brothers and sisters. I'm coming to you from the exotically wonderful, fabulously luxurious, snow flurried on the 7th, even though we're pretty far down here, awesome state of South Carolina. Hope y'all are all being blessed. And, you know, I'm sure it's cold where you are. It's been cold down here. We've had the Arctic blast and the Arctic vortex brought to you by the chemtrails of the, you know, the secret government of the United States and the world plans to dominate, to kill, steal, and destroy all of those who are not covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, also known as FEMA Region 4, here I am down here, way down south, brothers and sisters. Praise God that no matter where I go, I'm with Jesus. Hallelujah. So, brothers and sisters, I had made all these different things. I just want to do one now and stay on topic. I should just write it down and put it in front of me. You know, Jesus said, you know, the word the Lord I'm going to give you, he'll never leave you nor forsake you. He'll never leave you nor forsake you. Jesus said he'd be with us always, even to the end of the age. Our brothers and sisters, I need to qualify that. I need to qualify that statement. For the Lord said in his word, John chapter 15, he said, abide in me and I'll abide in you. I am the true vine. You are the branches. Abide in me that you may bear much fruit. My Father is the husbandman or the farmer. He will trim the branches, you know, prune you. The Lord, the Father will work on you. You know, it's painful to be pruned, but God will prune you so you can bear more fruit. Bear much fruit, Jesus said. But those branches that do not abide in the vine, well, of course, if you chop off a branch, it dies. And Jesus said, that's why Jesus said, that they'll be bundled up and cast into the fire. Now go ahead and smoke that in your greasy grace pipe and you figure out what that means. If you don't abide in Christ, well, then Christ won't abide in you. You'll be separated from the Lord. That's what I wanted to talk to you about, brothers and sisters, on that topic. Can you imagine if you're married to somebody and then you say, okay, I'm going to go live in Florida, and then my husband's going to live in New York, or vice versa. But we're married and we're in love, and we show our love to each other. But I, you know, I'm in New York and he's in Florida. Or my husband and I, or my wife and I, we live in the same house, but we don't speak. You know, I watch TV, and then they're on the internet all the time. And then, you know, this is how we express our love to each other, by doing our own thing. Brothers and sisters, this is the way that most people have their relationship, their quote-unquote relationship with Jesus. They don't read their Bible. They don't pray. They don't worship God. They spend all day long running to and fro, getting their news from coffee, you know, caffeine-riddled, you know, like the Lewis Black of preachers about the news. They get their, you know, all of this running to and fro trying to find out when the rapture is. But as a matter of fact, most of those that people don't even, the preacher I just was thinking of don't even believe in the rapture, but pre-tribulation rapture. But anyway, they're running to and fro on the internet, looking for all of these things, trying to calculate the rapture date, trying to figure out who, you know, all about the Antichrist and all that. But instead, they're not rooted and grounded in the Word. Now, and they're not having that relationship with the Lord. Now, brothers and sisters, let me say this as I'm thinking of it. I've made many videos about who, you know, the Lord, the things the Lord showed me about who's the Antichrist and about the things about God. But because I'm spending time with the Lord, that's how I got the wisdom from. You know, and then I come on and share that wisdom with those who are hungry to grow in the Lord. Not about people running to and fro who want to ride off of other people's, you know, other people's relationship with the Lord. You know, they're leeching, or what is the right word? Yeah, I guess they're leeching off of, vampiring off of other people's anointing, other people's relationship with the Lord. Now, brothers and sisters, we all have different gifts and talents to give to the body of Christ. You know, and as a preacher, as a servant of God, as really in a prophetic, I have a prophetic ministry. Of course, God gave me the anointing and the authority to operate in that office Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11, I have an office, a ministry office that I operate in. It's not the same as the gifts of the Spirit that you see in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, but in an office, in the ministry office. Of course, I'm here on YouTube to give to those who God would call to hear the messages that He would give me. And brothers and sisters, so I'm not, it's nothing about that. It's about those brothers and sisters who are not abiding in Christ. The very ones, as I've said many times, the very ones who are running to and fro, listening to the latest sensational, exaggerated news stories that has nothing to do with the gospel. You know, there's no steadfastness in them. They're not rooted and grounded in the Word. They're not rooted and grounded in Christ. You know, they're like a wave tossed in the ocean. They're like a candle in the wind. You know, as it says in James, it's quoted in that song, "Who am I?" You know, by casting crowns, they are a wave tossed in the ocean. They're just here today and gone tomorrow. They're grass that's withering in the noonday sun, because it's just like Jesus talked about the parable of the sower. He said some seed falls on the rocky ground. See, it starts to grow, but when tribulation comes. And I'm not talking about the tribulation. I'm talking about tribulation in your life. We all have tribulation, not talking about the tribulation. That when tribulation comes, when hard times comes, when the bright sun is shining and there's no rain, there's no anointing that they're using a gutter to reach out and steal the rain from somebody else's worship, try to put it on themselves, keep themselves growing on that rocky ground. They don't have any roots. So when the strong time comes, they're gone. Now, brothers and sisters, I should have come on strong with this message back in 2012. I mentioned it several times, but people aren't listening. They don't want to hear it. Those people, they've already fallen away. There are tons of people, even I know people that were on YouTube making videos about the rapture is going to be tomorrow in 2011. They're backsliders today. They are backsliders today. They've walked away. Tons of people that God woke up by His grace and mercy. Those backsliders, He woke up in 2011. Many of them have already fallen away because they're not rooted and grounded in the Word. They're not abiding in the true vine. Now, I know that all of you guys, and 99% of people watching this video, I'm just preaching to the choir. You guys know this. But I'm telling you this so you can share it with those other people, brothers and sisters. That's why I'm talking to you about it. Every once in a while, I'll step on somebody's toes and then they'll, you know, I can tell I stepped on their toes. They'll give a negative vote on the video or they'll make some obnoxious comment. You know, but brothers and sisters, I'd rather offend somebody to sow that seed that they might have an ear to hear, that they might repent. God called me to sow the seeds that He gave me to sow, brothers and sisters, and I will. And the seeds is abide in Christ and He will abide in you. He's the true vine. He will never leave nor forsake those who abide in Him. He will never leave nor forsake you. Don't walk away from the Lord. It tells us in Luke, Jesus says, those who do not take up their cross daily and follow me is not worthy of me. Go look up where the Bible verse is. Go use eSword or Google it. Jesus said in Luke, not in Matthew, He doesn't use the word daily. In Luke, He says, those who do not take up their cross daily and follow me is not worthy of me. Brothers and sisters, here's a key to this whole thing. Psalm 91. The Psalm 91 is a key and an easy way to understand what I'm trying to tell you, brothers and sisters. Verse 1, Psalm 91, verse 1. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my strength. You know, my strong tower, my deliverer. In Him shall I trust. The Lord, down in this psalm, when He says, you know, 1,000 will fall at your right hand, 10,000 at your 1,000 at your left hand, 10,000 at your right side, will not come nigh you, will not come near you. Why will the pestilence not come near? Why will the Lord deliver you from the noisome pestilence and from the snare of the fowler, you know, the foiler? Why will the Lord do that? On down there in Psalm 91, it's only about 10 verses or 15 verses. You can take the time and read it. And abide in Christ. It says, because He, the person who God will deliver, has set His love upon me. Because you or me have set our love upon the Lord. Because we've set our love upon the Lord, then he will deliver us. How do I set my love upon the Lord? That's where I started this video. How do I know that I've set my love upon the Lord? See, as they say, actions speak stronger than words. Actions speak stronger than words, more loudly than words. All these people saying they're a Christian, Jesus said, by their fruit you'll know them. And what is the fruit that Jesus wants? How do we abide in him? It's not just lip service, running all over the place and babbling and calling people names and all this stuff people doing on YouTube and running to and fro and all this coffee, adrenaline, junkie, latest breaking news in the world and all of this nonsense, trying to follow the law and all those other things. Greasy Grayson, just living like hell and thinking you're going to heaven. What does it say? Psalm 91 says, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Dwelling in the secret place of the Most High God. Spending your time with the one you love. Spend your time with the one you love. You know, but most of you practice the hippie slogan from the 1960s or 1970s. You know, if you can't be with, like that song, if you can't be with the one you love, love the one you're with. You know, that's what lots of alleged Christians do when they're out in the world. They go to a bar, they're all loved up with the devil, loved up with getting liquored up and having a big time in the world. They're loving the world that they're with instead of being with the one they love. Brothers and sisters, if you love me, Jesus said, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. If you love me, you'll keep my commandments. That's what Jesus said. What is his commandments? He did not talk about the law. He said, you know, a new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you, so the world would know that you're my disciples, because we have one love for another. Brothers and sisters, Christians would love each other. That's a commandment that the Lord gave us. You know, the commandments the Lord gave us is, you know, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. The golden rule, they call it. That came from the mouth of Jesus. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. You know, so brothers and sisters, praise God. I want to cut this off without getting off into a tangent. I've got other videos to make. So praise God. Praise God. Set your love on Jesus. Spend time with the one you love. And in your life, if you're married, you should spend time with your husband or wife and your children and all those things. But first, things first, that's the Lord. He's got to be number one in our lives, brothers and sisters. He's got to be number one. And that's the thing. People put other things first. Even putting your husband or wife, and one of the biggest things I see, too, people exalting their wife as an idol and a god above the Lord. Talking about they're serving the Lord. Being a mighty prophet of God, but their wife is exalted above the Lord. No such thing. No such thing. No such thing. God uses those who put him first. You got to put him first. You got to put the Lord first in your life. Set your love upon the Lord. Praise God Almighty, through whom all blessings flow. All good things come from above, the Bible says. All good things. God is the one who feeds us, like the little children's prayer. You know, by his hand we are fed. Give us, Lord, our daily bread. He's the one who feeds us by his own hand. Praise the Lord, we are his sheep. Set your love on the Master, and he will bless you with all things in this life and in the life to come, brothers and sisters. Put your trust in Jesus.